You break it, you buy it. That's the case at most retail stores, but not Pennsylvania state liquor stores.
The result, a hefty tab for taxpayers. Channel 4 Action News investigator Paul Van Osdell is in our newsroom with the story. Paul?
Well, Mike, we obtained this internal report showing broken bottles cost the state $500,000 a year. The cost of lost or stolen booze, another $2 million. And critics say this is one more reason that state government should get out of the liquor business. This state store in East Liberty is known for its great wine selection, but now it has another distinction, Western Pennsylvania's leader in broken bottles. Last year, more than $10,000 worth of booze ended up broken. Customers were surprised to hear that.
Does it concern you that we're actually losing money on all this broken
booze?
It
certainly does. Anything that loses money in these hard times, I think we want to do away with and try to find a way to make it work better.
Is that why we're paying more and more and more money for everything? Basically, that's what it is, because we're paying for their mistakes.
But not just the mistakes of store clerks. At most retail stores, the policy is you break it, you buy it. But at the LCB, it's completely the opposite. If you break it, they'll replace it. We decided to test their policy, so we bought a bottle of wine at the state store in Edgewood, and then we broke it. We collected the fragments and took them back to the state store. The manager threw out the bag of broken glass and gave me a new bottle. No questions asked.
Here it is. Nice bottle of wine.
The Liquor Control Board defends their policy, saying as a percentage of total sales, their breakage, loss, and theft numbers are actually below the national average for retailers.
However, it's never acceptable, and we're always working towards making sure that we're working as best we can, efficiently and effectively, to maintain that number and bring it down.
1739.
In Ohio, private businesses like Gino's Drive-Thru in Youngstown sell liquor. The sign inside, all sales are final.
So what do you think of the Pennsylvania policy that they'll replace it if you break it, even if it's not in the store?
They must have a lot of money. It just doesn't make any sense to be that easy in terms of allowing people to come back after they were careless.
Add to the breakage totals about $2 million a year lost because of missing or stolen liquor. This store in Pleasant Hills had more product lost or stolen than any other store in Western Pennsylvania. Nearly $18,000 worth last year alone. At Saul's store in Youngstown, he has 15 cameras, but that's not all he does to stop theft.
I've chased people down the street. I've gone into the Brambles. I pulled the liquor out and filed the charges and seen him taken away in handcuffs.
Do you think a bureaucrat in Pennsylvania who's running the state store there would do something like that?
Of course not.
Why not?
Because they really don't have, they're not personally affected.
The LCB tells me if a customer returns a bottle of wine that's spoiled, they will charge that cost back to the wine company. But as for bottles that are broken, the LCB does admit they absorb that cost. They say they're doing it as a courtesy to their customers.